In 2005, Skype was the future. Free video calls with anyone, anywhere, it was like magic. It changed how we communicated with family, friends, even colleagues. But now in 2025, after almost 20 years of service, Skype is being officially retired. The once unstoppable communication giant is being phased out. And while that may seem like the end of just another app, there's a deeper, more important lesson here, especially for those of us working in tech. Because if it can happen to Skype, it can happen to your skills, to your job, even your entire career, if you're not paying attention. Let's break down what happened and what it means for you. Let's rewind. Skype is launched in 2003 by a team from Estonia, Sweden, and Denmark. The goal was making internet-based video and voice calling free and simple. And it worked. Skype exploded. By 2005, it had over 70 million users and was bought by eBay. A few years later, Microsoft bought it for a jaw-dropping $8.5 billion. For many of us, it was our first remote work tool or our go-to way of calling home. It literally became a verb. Let's Skype tonight. It helped shape the digital communication era, but even the giants can fall. So why Skype is being shut down in 2025? It didn't collapse overnight. It slowly faded away. There were three key reasons. First, innovation stagnation. Skype stopped evolving fast enough. The UI didn't improve meaningfully. It became bloated and buggy. Second reason was poor user experience. People wanted fast, seamless video calls, but Skype felt clunky compared to Zoom, WhatsApp, and FaceTime. And third reason is really funny, because it's about Microsoft confusion. Ironically, the company that bought Skype also created its replacement, Microsoft Teams. Eventually, Teams overtook Skype in usage and importance, especially in the business world. As Zoom became the default and Teams took over corporate communication, Skype slowly lost its place. Not with a bang, but with silence. So why does this matter to you, a developer, engineer, or tech professional? Because Skype's retirement is a brutal reminder that nothing lasts forever. Even massive platforms can become obsolete if they don't adapt. The same is true for your skills. Maybe you're killing it right now. Great job, great stack, and great pay. But the tools you love today, the methods you rely on, even the way you think about your career could be outdated in just a few years. Tech doesn't wait for anyone. And career relevance is not something you own. It's something that you maintain. So how do you avoid becoming the Skype of your team or your industry? Here's my three-part system that's helped me stay on top of things. First, learn one new thing every month. It doesn't have to be huge. Just pick a concept, tool, or language and go one layer deeper. For example, use a Rust side project. Explore how LLMs are integrated into developer workflows. Learn a new DevOps or CI/CD tool. Next, teach you what you learn, whether it's YouTube, a tweet thread, or a quick LinkedIn post. Teaching is the best way to remember. It also builds your personal brand, which adds long-term value. And last, self-audit every quarter. Ask yourself, are the skills that I use every day still in demand? Is there a newer, faster way to solve this problem? Am I getting too comfortable? Because getting too comfortable, that's how it starts. There's something that I call the keep climbing rule. In tech, the ladder is always moving. If you're not climbing, you're slowly sliding down. Skype stopped climbing. It relied on its early success, its brand name, its market share, and ignored the changing needs of users. That's how it got replaced. Your career works the same way. You might be respected now, but are you still growing? Still curious? Still useful? Because success isn't permanent, but growth can be. So yes, Skype is being retired in May 2025. And while that may feel like the end of an era, it's also the beginning of a lesson that we should all take seriously. Adapt or fail. Build or be replaced. Stay curious or risk becoming irrelevant. Whether you're coding, managing, designing, or leading, the moment you stop growing is the moment you start fading. So don't be like Skype, be better. If this video gave you something to think about, please give it a thumbs up and drop a comment below. What tool or skill have you stopped using recently? And hey, please hit subscribe. I've got more career and tech insights every week. So see you in the next one.